Ma'am, the first time you were introduced to the Gully rap scene in India?
I was actually editing my film Dil Dhadakne Do, and my editor Anand Subbaiah showed me this video, which was a track called Afat by this 21-year-old kid called Malaysia. And I couldn't believe what I was watching. I mean, I've always followed hip hop, but I haven't really engaged with the scene in India. And I just kept re-watching it, and then called some friends of mine in the music industry and found him, and now I'm here.
When Zoya mentioned that she wants to make a film on the lives of hip-hop artists and wants to explore that thing, I was really excited because I know that she loves the genre and she loves the music.
Aap yahan aaye hain, ek hip-hop gig ho raha hai, din mein ye kaam bari hai.
When I read the entire script, I thought this is a film that needs to be made. We've never like tapped into the whole hip-hop rap vibe in India in a film, so that's very exciting.
I was in tears at the end of the narration, and even she was in tears, and she said, this has never happened. I've never like been in tears narrating my own script.
Having already collaborated with Zoya, I trusted that her material is going to be something that is really going to grab me.
It's a story of a boy from the wrong side of the track who, because of his own talent, sort of is able to jump the glass ceilings that society sort of puts on people.
And eventually breaks through as a bona fide hip hop artist. And I was like,
खड़ा हूँ कैसे मैं यहाँ पे अब ना पूछना दर्द शायरी में तुझको चाहिए सबूत क्या शिखर ये सोच पर जुड़ा हूँ मैं जमीन से यकीन तुमको ना पर आ गया या मैं यकीन से
लाख नफरत फिल्म इज अबाउट अ बॉय हु डिस्कवर्स हिज वॉइस थ्रू रैप एंड इन एडवर्टेंटली हिज आर्ट मेक्स हिम ट्रांसेंड हिज क्लास I wrote the film with Reema Kagde, and we knew there was something here, so we did extensive interviews with people. The two people that we just kept coming back to, and they became our touchstone on the film, Divine and Nazy. They were the stories that most resonated with us. They were the people that actually we got on with the most, you know.
I mean, I have to say, Nazy and Divine for us was like, you know, they were so inspiring. It was so lovely to, you know, it was just too good. It was delicious material, and it was fab as a writer.
असल में जब research work जो था इसका उसमें हमारा काफी मिलना जुलना होता था. उन्होंने एक बार visit किया बॉम्बे 70 हमारा area. तो मैंने उनको दिखाया कि कितना अलग अलग सीन है एरिया में मतलब क्या क्या चलता है
They were very strong, and then at the last stage, I gave the script to a couple of people because I wanted a particular kind of lingo. And I gave the first 10 pages to a few writers, and Vijay was amazing. He just leapt off the page. And what we did was we had four of the rapper boys. So there was Emmy Mantai, there was Kambhari, there was MC Altaf, and there was Rahul Piske, who plays Chintu the beatboxer. Four of them would come in with us, and then Vijay would narrate the whole. Script to them, and they would tell us, no, we wouldn't say this, we would say it like that. We would, so all the slang and the lingo and all that stuff came from them. And Vijay was very respectful of that process because it was very important to me.
I can't tell you what a blessing it is to have guys like Altaf, Rahul on the set. These guys just come in, it takes them like seconds to come up with something like a garnish on the dialogues. That just complete the scene. Amaze.
you could say in a way that Murad is a very real, a very authentic, but a very private side of me.
Murad is somebody who's a poet, and he's got a talent. He's got a talent to write and hear from music. I mean, I can't imagine anyone else playing Murad besides Ranveer. He was born to play this part.
I think the tough transformation for him was he had to actually morph his body, and he was twice his size, literally. And I think that must have been very hard for him to do in such a short span of time.
Ranveer is a fabulous actor, so when he was on set, he was like Murad, and everything about him was very Murad-like. So I actually got to see a very calm, collected, simple version of Ranveer that I don't think many people have had.
Zoya and I were having conversations about who's going to be the voice of Murad in terms of who's going to rap. And she told me that Ranveer raps.
In my head, I was always going to be voicing the songs.
Like, Ranveer was very clear he wanted to rap. And I mean, that was in my head, that it would be ideal if he was the voice for Murad. And I've heard him, but you know, it's another thing when you're in a studio and you have to rap 5 tracks on an album. But he came in and he slammed it, so we knew the first day in the studio that he's on.
देखो तो इधर मेरे गली में है घर छोटे छोटे लेकिन जरा देखो दिन में है जगह भी शुमार दे पुकार कभी भी गली से मदद देने को तैयार
गली भी चलेंगे लेकिन फरी भी करेंगे नहीं चली भी तलेंगे लेकिन फटेली रुकेगी नहीं जहाँ भी चलेंगे बोले हटेला झुकेगा नहीं क्यों क्योंकि हटेला है मेरी गली का तरीका साली काटी केला है
kick ass this one
sounding good
Yeah, this is it.
Yeah.
Kick ass. Roshan chok ke ugly bawali hai, ronak
bomb ki shali kamali hai, sau pat bahut something very very extra special about this mic and those speakers there they are actually the first mic and the first speakers that Divine used when he first recorded special
I knew it from day one that he's the only guy who can pull off this character and he's been in studio with me too I've been on set also and it's amazing
Oh. Action!
हाथ मत लगा.
You don't need to get physical. आराम से बात कर सकते हैं.
आराम से फिर
हाँ.
Ow!
Oh. Alia tried to break that bottle on my head many times and it just wasn't working. Like one bottle didn't break. Like I don't know if my head is just not hard enough or what it was, but it was really stressful that night. That night was really stressful. By the end, I was really scared of Safina.
Safina. Like,
Safina is mad. Like, I remember even while listening to the narration, every scene was a revelation. I was like, okay, she said something, and I was like, what? And then she said something more, and I was like, are you serious? And then it just went on, and she's like, yeah, wait. Like, just wait for it. It's coming.
She's somebody who was academic, who was bright, who was feisty growing up as a child. She wants to win. She's got that personality.
I think Alia's just, you know, taking it out of the park. I mean, I love what she and Zoya have done to the character. Because, she, you know, even on paper, she was one of my favorites.
She's somebody who's so bright and so focused and so goal-oriented and knows what she wants to do. We told how she can live her life just because she's a female would be something that would really frustrate her and anger her. For her, Murad is like her childhood sweetheart and he's someone who just kind of lets her be. So he is also symbolic of freedom. Whenever that freedom kind of is threatened, she wakes.
तू शुक्र कर उसकी गर्दन नहीं तोड़ी मैं अभी एक ही लाइफ है एक ही तो है ऊपर से वो घुस रही है बीच में गुस्सा नहीं आएगा क्या
She according to me is one of the finest actors of Hindi cinema
I had a blast working with her I think when we work together we really kind of feel excited by each other's performance So that really helps when you're doing a film like this, and especially when the characters are supposed to be having such a strong connect. I think it came out pretty well, at least on set. So I'm really looking forward to what people see and what people feel.
Gully Boy?
Yeah.
Hi, I'm Sky.
Sky is a bit like me, I suppose, you know? She's in there, she wants to do something, she wants to go and see what is going on, where is the subculture, what's going on. She comes from privilege, but she's a bleeding heart.
She really cares about her art, and she really, that is, ultimately, she has, you know, a sort of respect for the arts and for anyone who has talent. And
तुमको मालूम है मैं किधर से
तो आर्टिस्ट हो कहाँ से आए हो क्या लेके आए हो क्या फर्क पड़ता है
There are some actors who you don't realize when you're acting with them in person live in front of them you don't realize everything that it is that they're doing it's only when you see the scene back when you see it edited and you see Wow, and Kalki is one of those actors.
I love working with Kalki. I'm very comfortable with Kalki. I mean, if I could cast Kalki in every job I did, I would. I love working with her. She's extremely unique. She's special. She comes in, she always gets something fresh. I feel she's got something very vulnerable, you know, and she's very edgy. She's very cool. She's all that. But she's there's something very childlike. There's something very vulnerable. And there's something very honest about Kalki.
Chalo, 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 bhai log.
I love the party. Kya bolte lady? Bajate kuch old school hip hop banger.
Old school banger.
Abhi ye log sher ke saath nachenge. Kya?
MC Sher was the most worrisome character because I needed somebody with a lot of presence and I needed somebody who can tower over Ranveer.
कुछ लिखे ना हूँ भाई। तुमको सही लगा? तो बक डालो।
तेरी गानी तेरे को नहीं बोलनी तो मैं क्या को बोलूँ?
He is fairly new, he's new compared to me. But our status is very different in the film. The dynamic is very different in the film. His character is somebody I look up to. Whereas in real life, you could say in a way that it's the exact opposite.
So I signed the film 20 days before the shoot started. Very less time to prep. यहाँ पे equation पूरा अलग है शेर का. I have to be like a big brother to him. So I was like, कैसे करेंगे यार? मतलब he was like, bro, तू कर अपना. Whatever you're doing, just do it. Don't feel any hesitation. I mean, we have to develop a chemistry, and that will only happen if you forget that I'm Ranveer Singh.
Rap kya hai? Rhythm, poetry. Poetry darwaza hai. Bas thoda rhythm mein aa ja mere raja.
He asked me one question. He was like, "What do you mean by Sher? Is he a tiger or a lion?" And I was like, "He's a lion." And he went home and he just studied lions. He just watched lions, and you can tell that in his body language. Like one of those heartbreak characters, you know. I love Moeen actually, and Moeen has the biggest arc in the film.
I was extremely happy that I'm getting to work with Zoya Akhtar. When I finally read the script, I was pretty blown by what they've written, and at the same time, I was very excited about this part, the part of Moeen.
It's a tough part to play because you need to, you know, you need to not like him.
He's a survivor and he's a hustler in the true sense. He's probably on the wrong side of the law at times, and but he just makes sure that he survives this day.
There's a certain brokenness, I don't know if I should be saying this, about Vijay Varma that's very attractive.
तू मेरे बच्चों को खाना खिला ना दोनों टाइम का खाना खिला और धारावी 17 का खतरा दिखाते जाके सबको मच्छन कर दे क्या बोलता है
It's a boys' gang essentially, and there's lots of different characters. A lot of them are getting colored because you live in the slums or you're out of the streets a lot. You do have that natural color.
The thing is, what is fun about Gully Boy is that all the looks that we have to create are basically very non-glamorous looks.
I trust Avan blindly, so I don't even ask. You know, she brings that kind of value.
Avan played around with my hair a little bit. They asked me to grow my hair, my nails. I've not touched anything for the past 3 months.
They have these darker knuckles and around the nails, teeth, skin, breaking up skin, freckling, eyes drugged out. You know, it's lots of little things. So it's actually putting it together so it doesn't look like makeup.
We've created this look for him particularly. We've given him the hoodie on top of the kurta and we kind of made a stock with like all the fabrics we had and all the prints and patterns and colors we wanted in the film. We picked costumes from different racks for individual characters from that.
Once you start looking like the character, you know, it's like external to internal, outside in kind of process where you weirdly start feeling like the character.
बकरी को निकालो यार शॉट में से
It's MCL tough, enemies, tere samne, huh?
When you have Zoya Akhtar making a film and she knows what she wants, she has brought together the finest collection of health department.
Go on a roller coaster ever, that's how you're going to be.
Roller coaster!
What is this?
But the vibe is amazing. I look forward to coming to shoot every day because there's such fun people around.
There were times where we were like shooting and people were waiting to cross the bridge and they were not even interested in us, they just wanted to get to their destination. So one imagines locations like this to be really difficult, but they were super chill.
While we were discussing the film, a lot of filming had to be done in the streets and the outdoors on the terraces. And Zoya was very clear about not using chroma keys and green screens or blue screens and then do set extensions.
This is not a film you can do in Film City. You've got to be there and you've got to be in the middle of this. We were very aware that we had stars and there were two reasons. We had stars and the second thing was that because we had so many days in the middle of Dharavi, we were shooting day and night. We cannot disturb a community.
We were in Dharavi and we're on a rooftop terrace. And we're looking for basically a space in Dharavi, just like some sort of like available land that we could potentially build our set on. And it was actually from that vantage point, which was about like 18 stories high, and we just basically spotted this open space, which actually turned out to be a parking lot.
When we saw this parking lot, it's bordered with like Dharavi factories, and then you see everything around it. It puts the character into context immediately. Then you know, okay, this is where he is, and these are all the other possibilities of where he could go to.
And Suzanne was very clear that she will reconstruct a set of 70 to 80 slum houses and a couple of lanes. And the first time I walked in and I was blown away. I think it was fantastic. It was so real.
I don't know if you've noticed there's no blue in the film. We decided to take blue out as a color from art. So you know the blue tarpaulin that's so famous in Bombay, which is really kind of an eyesore. We took it out.
And that is what we like walked around a lot through the course of the film because that was something
we had erased blue from every place in the film, so you won't see any blue. Even if you are seeing, like, you'll see it in a faint, like a very strange sort of a faint blue or something, but that was very strictly followed.
A lot of these musicians are really young. As I said, they are 19 years old, 20 years old. They've even acted in the film. They've written stuff for the film. And it's a big step in creating heroes out of them.
So people have been hearing very formula-based music in Bollywood for quite some time. And I realized that there's this major shift coming in the underground hip-hop scene. With very limited resources, trying to produce the music they want to produce, they're getting a total chance here to do what they really love to do. It's a unique soundtrack altogether, if you hear.
गंगार वाले
बीट में ड्रॉप करूं झंकार वाले
झंकार वाले
एक नंबर आज तो गर्दी है भाई गर्दी है
गर्दी है
जमावट जमावट है बापला
It was a very fulfilling process being in the studio, collaborating with Divine, collaborating with Ankur. The youngsters as well, they're bursting with music, they're bursting with creativity, and they come with that energy and they feed and pump the film with that energy. Musicians are extra passionate people, you know, so just to be around that infectious passion is just lovely.
It like it's family to me now, you know, and I really wanted to give in my 100% is because it's now or never, and this is the right time. We should take this very far from here now. We have the torch.
They have a way of taking something that is that moves them and putting it out in a way that resonates with a bigger, larger audience. And they do it. They do it in their way. It's not copied, you know. So there was no way to go with anyone else. It had to be them. They had to produce it. They had to write it, and only then could it have sounded the way it did.
But hip-hop scene, उन लोगों को मालूम है, उन लोगों को दिल से ऐसे लगता है कि ये अपनी पीछे चाहे कोई लिख रहा है, कोई स्पीड कर रहा है, कोई अपीयरेंस कर रहा है, कोई जो भी कर रहा है ना, वो दिल से कर रहा है.
Guys, settle down in your positions, please. Can you guys come pick up?
I think like they're all heroes in their own right. They were waiting for a kind of a spotlight, which the film will give them.
I think that, you know, the Gully Boy story doesn't end with just the film. Now that all these artists
This is going to be a different scene after this. I mean, phatne wala hai bolte hain.
Aaj ke time mein aisa hai ki hip hop pe movie ban raha hai. Bollywood mein hogi. Bollywood bhi samajh gaya ki ye hip hop hai.
I think if hip hop didn't come into India the way it has, I mean, to be honest, it didn't even come to India. People enhanced, they captured hip hop and they used it for speech.
Hum sabhi ke liye bahut acha ho raha hai aur underground hip hop ka pura scene aur bada hota ja raha hai.
एक ही रास्ता जिस पे चुपचाप सर को झुकाए हुए बंद आंखें किए लोग सारे जन्म चलते हैं जानते भी नहीं सोचते भी नहीं पूछते भी नहीं उनको ये रास्ता लेकर कहीं जाएगा या कहीं भी नहीं चलते चलते एक मोड़ आता है सीधे रास्ते से बिल्कुल अलग कोई दीवाना ही होता है जो कि उधर जाता है वरना बाकी तो सब सीधे रास्ते पे ही अपने सारे जन्म चलते हैं सर झुकाए हुए बंद आंखें किए और ये दुख लिए मोड़ जो देखा था उस पे मुड़ जाते हम तो ना जाने कहां तक पहुंच पाते हम
I was just I just didn't want to have made a movie that didn't speak their truth.
Well, believe it or not, Gully Boy is a big